Better reaction was Pomponio, but you saw him pedal it, and it is game, set, match, and national championship for Sean Bellemeur.
Hello, everybody. I'm Brian Lohnes from the NHRA on Fox here at the NHRA East Coast Wally Park Studio, catching up and whipping around the world of NHRA drag racing with some of our racers, both in the Lucas Oil Drag Racing Series and the Mellow Yellow Series. And it is one of the big stars of the Lucas Oil Drag Racing Series, back-to-back defending top alcohol funny car world champion, Sean Bellemeur. How you doing, man?
You know, we're safe and we're healthy, and I still got a job, so that's a good thing, but you know, like everybody else, chomping at the bit and just one day at a time, man. It's good to see your smiling face, I'll tell you that.
Same to you, and it's good to see your office decor there, man. That is a drag racer's dream setup. As we look over your shoulders, we see a lot of great hardware there. And, you know, the 2019 season was one on so many levels for you that it would be very difficult to top. But let's just talk a little bit about winning that Alcohol Funny Car Championship back-to-back. Did you feel it a little bit heavier near the end of the season when you were trying to lock it up than you did maybe the first time?
You know, it's funny because in 18, when we, you know, when we put the deal together with Bartone, it was just a, hey, we've had a lot of success, but, you know, part time, let's swing for the fence, give it all we got. And we ended up having a phenomenal year. Rolling into 19, there was definitely more pressure. I definitely felt, you know, the competition around us. I mean, you saw the formation of two super teams just coming after us with Rick Jackson and Shane, and then Brian Howard with Johnny Lindbergh. I mean, you know, that happened because of what we did in 18. And so definitely felt it, and, you know, and then of course you've got your own expectations to try to match what you did the year before. But it was funny because we had, you know, the new car blues, so to speak, at our first race in Gainesville last year at the Baby Gators. Literally a wire fell off the thing. I mean, we were low ET, we were top speed, we were checking all the boxes to win the damn thing. And then a wire falls off and we, and the car shuts off. So, you know, it was, as the season progressed, we actually, you know, I say stumbled, you know, any other time in my career, I'd say it's a highlight year, but we actually stumbled a little bit and found a problem. And I still tell people the round of the year for us last year was losing second round in Indy, because it put a big old target on the computer screen for us as to what went wrong, what's going wrong with this car. And finally Boggs found it. And then we were able to start reeling off some round wins. So that was a, it was definitely a roller coaster last year. It was very different, you know, but with the same end result than 2018.
You were, like so many of us were, basically on the way to or at the racetrack at the Gator Nationals in 2020 when that race came to a screeching halt, and really the season did at that moment as well. How are you guys equipped and I maybe say even better equipped than some teams to deal with what's going to be a very interesting restart once we get going? I feel like the experience that you have amongst all of you puts you in a good spot.
Yeah, definitely. And you know, like you, I made it as far as Atlanta. I was on my way to Gainesville, and, you know, you turn your phone on when you land, and all of a sudden my phone started blowing up, and I was actually able to get a flight out of Atlanta and return home. So I just did an Orange County to Atlanta to Orange County day. But, you know, my team was there. We had run the Baby Gators the weekend before. So the majority of my guys were actually still there, and the car was prepared. I mean, it's literally sitting at the shop in New York, ready to hang a starter on it. So, you know what, there's two sides of that question for me, the guy that's the driver for Tony Bartone, and then the guy that has a budget race car with my dad. You know, driving for Tony, I feel like we're probably going to be the most prepared team out there. You talk about lucky. I'm the lucky guy to where we've got parts, we got people. Steve Boggs, what I need to do with Steve is get him out of his house, because he has got more ideas, more. Oh, man. I mean, you know, short of launching rocket ships out of Ohio in his backyard, he's ready to go. So we got to get him back to the track so he can, you know, he can work his magic. But, you know, we're all you know, we're ready to go. I'm, you know, just waiting for the green light. Now, you know, a team like my dad's, where we are, you know, very tight budget, typically run on the West Coast, we're just gonna have to wait and see. You know, it's the way the point system comes out, the way, you know, Justin Taylor is a real good friend of mine with Taylor Motorsports products, a lot of the safety equipment. And he said, Sean, we're dead quiet right now because nobody's racing. But he goes, once this thing gets going, shoot, there's going to be races every weekend and people want more. It's going to be very interesting to see, you know, whole picture here, what all is going to go down. I'm really glad that I got my team in my corner. I'll put it that way. You know, Tony spares no expense. Boggs has already got a plan. He goes, I don't care if we race in Gainesville in July or December, I'll have a tune-up for it. So, so my job's going to be the easy one. I just put the stage line on, point it in their direction, try not to run into anything. And that's the same whether I'm racing in the rain or the snow or the sun. So, I like where we're at. I just, man, can't wait to get the green light.
I got one last question for you before I let you go. What is the restaurant that you miss the most right now at home? You're a California guy. I'm sure there's a spot that you will be running to as soon as you're able to sit down at a restaurant and eat. What is that spot?
So there's a great little bar and grill place right around the corner from my house called Kelly's. And it's just a little local spot in Placentia, California. They have been doing to-go orders, but my wife and I go there on date nights. We literally walk there. They've got a 5-star chef. He is amazing. I miss Kelly's carnitas nachos and a cold beer with my wife.
That is a very good answer, man. Hey, it's great to see you, Sean. Glad to hear that you and your family are hanging in there and are safe at this time. And I can't wait to see you at the racetrack defending and trying to go for a three-peat in Top Alcohol Funny Car. Thanks for your time.
I appreciate it, guys. It'll be good.
That's it for this stop at the East Coast NHRA Wally Park studio. We'll be back with more racers and more conversations soon here on NHRA.com and across our NHRA social media platforms.